This might not seem like the obvious path, but I approached a few of the wealthier individuals I found on my social media and pitched them my company idea. See, the movie Wolf of Wall Street taught to me, never spend your own money when you can spend someone else's. I then created an internet startup company that specialized.
I don't know what the f- that was.
Hello there. You're watching Redditor. If you like the video, please like and subscribe. And, okay, look, I hate saying this stuff. I upload every day. Hit the bell if you want to make sure you see them. Video time. Enjoy. r/Askreddit. Millionaires of Reddit. How did you become so wealthy? I live in Eastern Europe. In 1990 I took out a huge loan and bought 10 apartments and furnished them. I rent them out to people, and with the money I earn from them, I pay off the loan payments. I do this every 10 years. I have now 30 apartments and one employee who I pay to maintain them and make sure payments and maintenance is handled. The key is finding good tenants and maintaining a good relationship with them. It is not that hard, but a key to this strategy. In my 20s, I was a computer programmer. Just as the web started exploding in popularity, I could wire up websites and databases back when internet technologies were new and tooling was still primitive. I never hit it big with a viral website like Facebook or Amazon, but I did charge a lot for programming services. And I used that money to buy houses at first, and ultimately an apartment building in coastal California. In my 40s now, I don't feel very wealthy really. Oddly, I still check prices when shopping, and I plan to drive my old Jeep until it dies. When I travel, I often pay to fly first class, and I do enjoy the nicer hotels. But, other than that, I live and spend rather simply. I enlisted in the army when I was 18. I liked it. I asked to become an officer, and they let me. The army sent me to college and I graduated. My officer pay was way higher, and in the army you don't have very many bills. I found I could save in between 1k and 5k every month of my life. After my second deployment I was sitting on about 200k. I hired a financial manager. He did well a few years. I've bought and rented out a couple houses. I've got 17 years in the army, creeping closer to a portfolio worth $2 million and a good pension in retirement. I'm about to make lieutenant colonel. I'm in my late 30s. Just grind and save. Edit. Gold. Thanks. I should add that this job really sucks, and I hate it a lot of the time. But due to the peaks and valleys of monetary motivation, I have to do it for a few more years. Being frugal. Not buying new cars. Not caring about what others think. Saving and investing and doing it again. Not making knee-jerk investments. Letting them ride long term, and not freaking out at every market correction. For me it was a slow game, but fun to watch it take off. Through hard work and perseverance I established a reputation for honesty and competence. I was slowly promoted to increasing positions of responsibility and remuneration. I saved prodigiously and invested wisely. I married well to someone with similar values. I'm on track of being a millionaire by just investing in my 401k. I started my career at 20 years old, right after graduating from college, and started investing the minimum to my 401k. Never really thought much of it until I did those calculators and realized that, since I started so young, the compound interest on any investment account with a decent return would be huge. I would recommend you just put anything away. Everyone tells you to maximum your investments, but honestly not everyone can invest $18k a year. Do the math of how much $200 a month will grow in 30 years. This might not be the exact answer, but this will easily get you to be a millionaire at some point. Not there yet, but getting there. STEM degree for both wife and I. I bag my lunch and drink from water fountain. I eat out with coworkers maybe once a month. Fill up my trusty clean canteen bottle daily with the free ice from cafeteria and water from the water fountain. In my lower 30s right now. Have a $500k house, bought 2 years ago, about 40% paid off. Hope to pay it off completely well, before I turn 40. Currently about $350k in bank between liquid and stocks. currently driving a 9-year-old Scion. Wife has a 13-year-old Camry. Daughter's toys are from the thrift store. Haven't had cable TV ever. Love Costco and Walmart. Love looking at deal sites. That doesn't mean we do not enjoy life. We've been backpacking in Europe. Have visited Dubai, Bahamas, Bermuda, Puerto Rico, Vegas numerous times, Canada numerous times, going to Cali in less than a month. My philosophy is this: you get rich by acting poor in things that really don't please your heart. We like traveling, so we do that. I like photography, so I have a DSLR. Wife likes nail polish, so she has like a big box full of them. I don't care much about food, so I bag it, and we rarely eat out. Same with our cars. Live simply. Invest and spend wisely. Love unconditionally. My first million was the hardest to attain. It took me a good 10 to 15 years to find the perfect bank near the highway, a safe cracker that's not a complete fornicating idiot, and an inside man that's not going to fold under a little bit of stress. Once I got my perfect team, getting the million was easy. The second was easier, now that I got some experience under my belt. This might not seem like the obvious path, but I approached a few of the wealthier individuals I found on my social media and pitched them my company idea. See, the movie Wolf of Wall Street taught to me: never spend your own money when you can spend someone else's. I then created an internet startup company that specialized in dog fart collection. I'm not a millionaire. I was born. It all came from my parents. I get a lot of crap from my friends in college, lol. My parents, on the other hand, went from living in lower middle class India, born in late 50s, so basically studying hard and family bonds were what kept them going, came to California for master's and PhD, and worked for massive tech companies for about 30 years. My dad went up to executive director or something. They invested a lot of money and bought houses in India and rented them out. The house they bought here in California went from $1.1 million to about $3.5 million. Is millionaire defined by assets? Because I just qualify based on the value of my property, but I'm shit poor in terms of cash flow. I have always been very frugal and save significantly more than anyone else I know. Bought a property at the age of 23 which appreciated in value by a significant amount. However, I'm just barely paying off the loan, so I'm poor as fornicate. Self-made. Cracked the first $1 million just after 33 sometime. Then the next few came quickly. The best advice is to build capital early. I scrimped and saved, and had my first car till I was 30 and it totally shat itself. Didn't waste money on holidays or any expenditure that wasn't 100% necessary. Holidays consisted just of time of work and going to beach or doing fun free things. So once I had a little nest egg $10,000, I got a house, and every time I had a spare $50 put it against the mortgage. Then every time I got a pay rise, the difference went to the mortgage, not to increase in lifestyle. I'm 45 now, and saving becomes less of a priority as the base capital is there. I can spend every cent I earn, and my base will still increase. Summary: get saving early. What car and what clothes you wear don't change who you are. What exactly is a millionaire? A million in net wealth, or a million in cash, or a million in assets, or a combo of? In ors, given your average house in a city is now worth half to three quarters of a million, and I have two, I guess, that makes me a millionaire, if I exclude the mortgage on the investment property. Not me, but my family. My dad was piss poor as a kid, because he was one of five kids to a single mother, since my grandpa died when dad was like 11 or 12. Moved out at 17, after getting his HSC, Aussie Sats. Went to work. Worked a lot. My dad's really smart, so he was good at what he did. Mum and dad weren't meant to be able to have kids, but when both of them were 40 they conceived me. Dad had just started his own business in the tech industry, but he believed in himself and the two mates he started the company with, and it boomed. Mum hasn't worked since I was born because she was taking care of me. When I went to school she started doing a lot of charity work. She fell pregnant again with my little brother, but he was still born when I was 3 years old, so I stayed an only child. This year both my parents turned 60 and my dad retired 'cause his businesses and was doing so well. We live in a nice house, but most of our money goes to charity anyway, since dad knows how it feels to have no money. What doesn't go to charity goes to family. I remember one year at Christmas dad gave his mum, my nana, and all four of his siblings $10,000 each, aka $50,000 in one year. I never asked for money. I got a job legally, as soon as I could, 14 and 9 months, and I've worked ever since while attending school. I think my dad gave me good work ethics. They never spoiled me, even though they could have. I'm 21 now, I still live at home, uni, and just started my first full-time job, but I plan to move out when I find a place I can take my dog with me. So technically my mum and dad are millionaires. I'm not. It's not my money, and when mum and dad pass I'll probably divide it up among the family slash charity. Going to a private high school taught me money doesn't buy you happiness, so I don't have any interest in keeping more than enough to be comfortable. I wouldn't have even thought about inheritance, but I was forced to cause my dad had two heart attacks this year and his dad's dad both died of heart attacks in their 30s. Not that anyone cares, but he's doing way better now, a few stents in, and a lot of rehabilitation and he's almost back to normal. Edit, I know I said I wasn't spoiled, but they did give me a car when I got my full license. Well, they didn't get me a new car, they bought a new one for themselves, and said I could drive the old one, and take it with me, if slash when I move out. So basically I was an 18-year-old driving a 3-year-old mid-range Lexus. I'm now a 21-year-old driving a 6-year-old mid-range Lexus. Most of my friends come from pretty poor areas, so I do get some looks when I'm in their neighborhoods. Or gum. Twice now someone has stuck gum on the inside of my door handles. What a hard life I lead. TLDR. Anyone who bought a house at the right time became a millionaire. Anyone who makes a shit ton and hoards money became a millionaire. Anyone who became the one in 1 million who ran a successful business became a millionaire. If you're in a field without a well-paying job, you're out of luck. And if you didn't buy a house at the right time, you're out of luck. Your only chance is to start a business and hope you make it successful. But if you fail, you'll get a shit ton of debt.
That's a 10.
Well then. Time to go get dad guap. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Oh, and if you liked the video don't forget to subscribe and like. Blah blah blah. Okay, now get out of here and do something fun. Everything doesn't have to suck. Oh Christ, I'm still typing.